Welcome in Python video series. In this video tutorial, we'll talk about typecasting in Python. We'll talk about the implicit and explicit typecasting in Python, right? So guys, as you know, when in Python, if you assign some value to any variable, let's say I assign 12 to A, then immediately Python is able to judge type of this variable is nothing but the integer, right? You can easily check by calling the type function, and there you have to pass this variable, and if you check, it will immediately tell you this is nothing but the int type, right? Similarly, let's say I have a variable is called b, and there I'm going to assign some floating point, right? And if you check the type of b, immediately it will tell you type of b is nothing but the float. Let me show you. So this is called implicit type casting, right? Similarly, if you have a variable is called c, and there you assign some value, let's say 12 plus 34 g, and if you look into the type of c, it will tell you it is nothing but the complex number, right? So let me show you. It is saying that complex, right? Easily you can identify. But sometimes, let's say if you have a string or you have an integer, but if you want corresponding float, or we have a float, sometimes you have a requirement to convert from float to integer, or sometimes you have a requirement to convert from integer to complex number, etc., right? Then we require some kind of inbuilt function which is available in the Python, right? So here we will look at predefined functions which can be used for explicit typecasting in Python. All these functions will give you value error if they are not able to do the type conversion correctly. So here I'm going to show you each and every function which help us to do a type casting, explicit type casting. So now I'm going to print, and first function I'm going to use chr, right? And chr here, this function, there you have to pass a number, and this function basically converts number to its corresponding ASCII character. Let's say I'm going to pass number as 65, and if I run, then this will give you the corresponding character of this ASCII value, right? Which is nothing but the capital A, as you know. Now let's talk about the next function. Next function I would like to talk about, the that's very well known, that is int. Yeah. So here I'm going to use int. Int, you can say that it is a function or constructor as well. And here you have to pass one string. Let's say I'm passing a string is called 1100, and after comma, that's completely optional. If you do not specify a second parameter specifies basically base of this a string equivalent number, right? So here what I'm telling to this constructor or this method, hey, I have this string, and this represents a base of 2, means this is the representation of binary equivalent of a string, and I want the corresponding integer value for this. Can you tell me? If I run, then this will immediately tell you, yeah, corresponding value in int or decimal is 12, right? So you can use int function. There you have to specify the string, right? And there you can specify the base. If you do not specify base, then this will take as decimal, right? Here you can specify for binary 2, for octal you can specify 8, and for hexadecimal you can specify 16, right? That's how it works. If you do not specify base, then it will take as decimal point, right? So it will print as it is, right? That's how basically int function works. Now next method I am going to show you, that is float, right? Let's say I want to convert from integer to float, right? So basically float function help us to convert any data type to a floating point number. Let me show you. So here I'm going to use a float. Okay, and here you can pass, let's say 23.45. So it will easily convert into the float. Let me show you. If I run, then this is printing. Even you can check the type of this guy. If you take type of this guy, So just I'm wrapping with function type, it will tell you it is a kind of float. Here you can see it is a float, right? So that means this float you can use to convert a given string into floating point number system. Yeah. Now next one I'm going to talk about a function that is called, something is called ORD. Yeah. So this function basically converts a character to integer, right? Let's say I'm specifying a, right? So ASCII value of a will be printed over here. Here you can see ASCII value of a is getting printed, which is nothing but the 65. Yeah, that's how you can use ORD. Now next thing I'm going to talk about hex. A function is called hex. Of course, while looking into the name itself, you can judge what the function, what is the functionality of hex. Basically, this function converts integer to hexadecimal string, right? So here, if I specify a number, let's say 15, then this will print the hexa equivalent of this will print the hexa equivalent of this number, right? And that is in a string. So if I run, then hexa equivalent of 15 is nothing but the F, and this is prefixed with 0x. 0x means hexadecimal, right? And that's how hex works. Of course, we have another method for octal as well, right? And that is nothing but the OCT, right? And if I run, then this will convert 15 into corresponding octadecimal number, and that is prefixed with 0o. If a number is prefixed with 0o, that means that is in octadecimal, that is in octa number system, not octa but hexadecimal, octadecimal system. Yeah, if number is prefixed with 0x, that means that is in hexa number system or hexadecimal system, right? Now I'll talk about the few constructor, right? So here I'm going to talk about the first constructor is called tuple, right? And there I can pass, let's say Python, right? So what happened, as you know, in Python, a string is nothing but the array, right? So this will convert, this string will convert it into the tuple. Let me show you. If I run, then here you can see a string is converted into a tuple, and that's how tuple constructor works. Similarly, if you have a tuple, then of course you will have a set and list as well, right? We have a list. So by looking into the name itself, tuple basically converts this string into the tuple, set converts into a set. So this curly bracket indicates that it is a set, and then a list, this is nothing but a list. So set always maintains the unique elements. So if you have some repeated characters in your string, then that will be removed while creating the set out of this string. Yeah, these things you have to keep in mind. Now next thing I would like to talk about is a function is called str, a string, right? So here I'm going to use str, right? And here let's say I'm going to pass 1 2 3, right? A number I'm passing that will be converted into the string. So let me show you. If I run, then this is converted into a string. But how we can identify whether this is a string or not? So of course you may use type function for this. So we can surround this with type function, and if you check, then it is telling it is a str, right? Last but not the least, I would like to talk about a function is called complex. So name itself saying that you can create a complex number using this function. So here you have choice to pass either one number or two number. If I pass only one number, that means I am passing only real part of the complex number. If I run this, then only real part is there, and in imaginary part 0j is there. But if you pass real part as well as imaginary part, let me show you. First I'm passing 12, and second number I'm passing 24. Then here you can see real part is 12 and imaginary part is 24, right? So that's how complex function works. So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial, guys. I hope you understood. this concept, if you learn this concept, then this concept is definitely going to help you while writing the complex code in Python. So guys, big thank you and see you there in the next video tutorial.